everybody, and welcome to MRTV. I am Maria, and today we are in the kitchen. Yes, we are in the kitchen today, you guys. So, what we're doing today is the first time for myself. I want to make fried chicken parmesan sliders, okay? So, this will be my first time. So, however it turn out, it's going to turn out, and we're going to be together. Okay, so, these are the things that I got. I have the Hawaii rolls. I have some panko, Italian breadcrumbs. I have some Barilla marinara, Parmesan cheese, that's the grated, and I have mozzarella shredded. And I have shredded Parmesan as well. And I am going with these. You may not can really see these too good, but I'm going with these. These are the thinly, can you see that? Thinly sliced chicken breast cutlets. Okay, so I'm gonna check these out. So hopefully they go all right. They're supposed to be real thin. We'll see just how thin they are when we get everything broke down and ready. And I have these two sweet potatoes over here because I want to do sweet potato fries with these. Trying to do a little something a little healthier. I'm going to bake them and not fry them. So we'll go through that process together as well. So let me get everything together and ready to go, and I'll be back. All right, so here are those chicken breasts. I wanted to show you just how thin they were. You see that? So therefore they won't be so thick. Now I do have this piece that's a little thicker than I want. It's just a tad bit thicker. So I'm gonna just take that rolling pin. I'm gonna put it in that plastic bag. And I'm gonna flatten it out just a little bit to get it a little thinner. See, that one got a little more thickness to it than that other one. This one here is pretty. Don't need to roll this one out at all. And then, yeah, you see this one? That one's kind of big. So I'm going to flatten that one out just a little bit more down on this end. And when I do that, then I'll be back for the next step. Okay, so I flattened these out a little more. So now it's just a little bit thinner. Might not can really tell, but they are thinner. Get this one out of here as well. See, that one's a little bigger and thinner up in here as well. Okay. All right. On to the next step. Okay, I'm just going to put some pink Himalayan salt and pepper on both sides. I'm not going to over season this little black pepper. Flip them over and repeat that step on this side. Then when I finish with this, I'm going to get my egg batter together, my egg wash, and my panko seed bread crumbs. All right, so I got that all seasoned. On to the next step. Okay, you guys, I'm just gonna shred this already shredded Parmesan cheese. I'm gonna just do it a little bit more because I don't want it in these long pieces. I want it more grind up. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead on and grind this up so it won't be all in y'all's ears, and I'll be right back. Alrighty. See? It's all ground up now. It's not these. Let me see if I can grab them. See these long pieces no more? That's what it used to be. But no more. Alrighty. See you in the next one. Okay. I got my eggs beaten. And this was just 3 eggs, so I hope it's enough. Then I have my Italian panko breadcrumbs. And this is that cheese that I had grinded up in my little bitty machine over there. Whatever. But all I want to do is I'm going to add a few more seasonings to these breadcrumbs here. You know, because I just like to make sure that it got a nice season to them. So I just add a little bit more garlic powder, just a little bit more onion powder, just some onion powder, I should say. Just a little bit more Italian seasoning. Just a smidge it, not too much. Just to make sure it has some good flavor. Then I'll mix all of this up. This is all fine. We'll get ready to batter it up in just a minute. Be right back. Alrighty. So it's time to get these boys battered up. So first, I'm going to put it in that shredded cheese. Okay. Make sure it's on there nicely, a nice little coating. Shake off the excess. I am so excited. I'm hoping this turns out very good. Y'all know how I do. Sure, I don't be knowing. I just be going for it sometime. Look at there. See that seasoning? Yeah. Lay that right over there. That turned out really well. We're going to take another piece. Get it really coated with that cheese. Did you all hear about the people who tried to kidnap our governor here in Michigan? Is that crazy? I was like, who does that? Who tries to kidnap, allegedly, a governor? Who? But it didn't go forward. They didn't get her, thank goodness. But who does that? I was like, they actually plotted to kidnap a governor. And she didn't even do anything wrong, to my knowledge. Alrighty, that's that one. So I'm going to bread up the rest, and then I'll be back. Okay, this is what we came up with. Look at that. It's nicely crusted all over. I'm really hoping this is good. So now we're about to go over to the skillet to get ready to fry. Okay, so now I have my oil in the pan. You don't need a lot of oil at all. You're not trying to deep fry or anything really close to that. And I put me some butter in here because I always like to give my oil some butter flavor, you know. And then the oil stops the butter from burning. So they kind of work perfectly together. Okay, so as soon as this heats up and get ready to fry, I'll be back. Alrighty, I think everything is a go with this grease. Let me see. Oops, sorry about my arm. I always do that. Okay, so we're gonna let these cook until they get nice and golden on one side. Not really too high, you know, but not too low, medium low type deal. But when it's time to flip, I'll be back. Alrighty, there they go, flipped over. And look how nice and golden and crisp the edges are. Like it's making a nice crisp coating. Mm. Alrighty, I'll be back after I have gotten all of them cooked up. Figured I'd give you a little close up. Look at that. You can see that Italian seasoning. Okay, so I got my rolls separated. Got my lids over here, my bottoms. And I got just a little bit of butter with a little garlic powder and some Italian seasoning. I just want to drizzle some of this on here, you know, so my bread won't be dry and it'll have a nice buttery flavor. You're not going to use all of this because you're going to need some for later. But you definitely want to make sure each bite got a little bit of that buttery taste. There you go. Save the rest. Now it's time to add the chicken. Alrighty. Time to add the sauce. Uh-oh. Really? Hold on. Alrighty. How many times I have to tell y'all this is real TV? I'm not editing that out. This is real TV. Stuff happens. It's not perfect. Okay. I don't want to put too much on it. It'll be overpowering. Alrighty. That's enough of that. Now it's time for the mozzarella cheese. Which you definitely don't want to be stingy with. Do not be stingy with your cheese. Okay. Who say you can have too much? Yeah, right. All right. Sprinkle more of that other cheese I had from earlier. Because I had put some to the side because I knew I'd need it. All righty. And then we put the top right here. Okay, and then we're going to put these in the oven. I got my oven set to 400, maybe 5 minutes or so, we'll see. But this is them ready to go in the oven. So, when they finish cooking in the oven, I'll be back. Y'all know what? Y'all play too much. Y'all didn't even tell me. I'm about to go put them in the oven, and I ain't even brushed them with this here. Butter. From earlier. With that garlic and Italian seasoning in it. Ooh, look at it dripping on the side, y'all. Ooh. Then after that, here we go with some more of that cheese. See what I'm saying? That's why you don't have to use it all up. You got to spread it out. Woo-hoo. Okay, so now it's going. Look at this. Ooh-wee. In the oven, you guys. And I'll see you when they're ready. Look, y'all. I had to step in real quick. Let me tell you something. This turned out great. Look at that. Gotta put it up there like that. Look at that. It turned out good. Yeah. That crunch. Without anything, this was good. I just had to step in, take a quick bite to see how it tasted without anything on it. And it is probably very good. I'll be back. I'm so excited. Look, you guys. Look, look, look. Let me see if I can get you in a little closer there. Look at the cheese coming down on that marinara sauce. You may not can see nothing really on that side, but look how toasted that bread is, nice and buttery. Look at that. Look at it. That actually turned out quite well. Let me try to get a plate or something to cut. I'll be back. All right, here we go, here we go, here we go. Let me see. Ooh, seemed like I got a little bit of, look at that. Look at that cheese falling all about, whatnot. Let me taste. That's definitely good. You should definitely make these. They turned out really well. The chicken was crusted and crunchy. The flavor was A1. So, definitely make it. I hope you enjoy it. If this is your first time watching MRTV, consider subscribing. Hit the notification bell for upcoming videos. Give this one a thumbs up, comment, and share. I would really appreciate it. And like always, you all have a blessed day. Peace.